So I'm on my annual pilgrimage to Winter Harbour, Vancouver Island, British Columbia. I've been going up here about 13, 14 years now. And I do that because the fishing's that good. And I, you know, I get some good episodes. And of course, I'm filming an episode this year, but this is also a place I like to fish myself and bring home a load of fish. It's a real high quality. What a kind of a real special place. You know, if you like bottom fishing, lingcod, rockfish, and halibut, and of course salmon. And this year, they're getting albacore already, which is kind of early. It's the middle of August. And so hopefully we're gonna get some albacore too, which would be kind of cool. So what I thought I'd do is give you a kind of a step-by-step breakdown along the way of how you get to Winter Harbour. And the great thing about Winter Harbour is you can drive to it, which makes it a lot easier to get all that fish back. So I've just got my truck here, my Corning Ford truck, and some things that I put on this truck kind of always, you know, every truck I've ever had last decade or so since I've been going to Winter Harbour. So I think about, you know, what I need for Winter Harbour, because it is it's a serious trip, you know, and it's not like you have to have a truck like this to get there. There's lots of cars that go there, but one thing you have to have are good tires, because that road, the last hour and a half or so to Winter Harbour, will test your tires. So, you know, good 10 ply tires or good quality tires are a big deal. And the canopy, I just got this on from my buddy's down in Totally Trucks in Reading, and I just love my shell here. These ARE shells or RE shells are really good. So, and a few things that you need, really. You don't need a lot. You know, you're gonna bring some fishing equipment probably. They do have equipment there, but you're gonna bring some of your own stuff maybe. And I like to put rods in a tube. A lot of people will rig them up with the reels on them and everything and have them all set up and put them in the back of the truck. But I've seen a lot of broken rods come out of backs of trucks. You know, bad things happen. You know, coolers fall over on them, equipment and things, and it's just, I just rather put in a tube. I've got my reels inside the truck there, and I'll rig them up when I get there, and that's fine. So, and then the other thing that's absolutely essential are some good coolers. I've got a Yeti 110 there and some other smaller Yetis, and that should give me plenty of space. The fish is gonna be packaged and frozen, so you can fit a lot of processed fish like that in a 110. If I was gonna bring back whole fish, like I have plenty of times in the past, then I'd want two nice big coolers, because you need more space, but also you wanna keep your salmon and bottom fish separate, because they'll taint each other. So that's pretty much all there is, besides, you know, rain gear and, you know, basic stuff you'd bring on a trip like this. So I've made it to the Black Ball ferry line here in Port Angeles. There are other ways you can go. Plenty of times we've gone up through Seattle and up to like Nanaimo, Tsawwassen, that crossing. So you're going through the I-5 crossing and over the border, which is not as simple as this for sure. But I just like this. It's just simpler coming here to Port Angeles and crossing over to Victoria. And what we're going to do is spend the night in Victoria. And that's a fun part of the trip right there, because Victoria is a really great town. So in the morning, we'll just get up and head to Winter Harbour, just, you know, basically driving the entire length of Vancouver Island, which is an experience in itself, you know. It's not a bad drive, you know, good road and everything, until you get to the dirt road. And it's not so bad. It's much better than it used to be. Yeah, but like I say, lots of carbs make it fine, no problem, but just make sure you've got good tires and you'll be fine. So a few hours, we're gonna get on the ferry here. Oh, and you know, think about ferries. Make sure, don't do what I did this year and didn't book my reservation ahead of time far enough, because I couldn't get a reservation. So I had to get here early and make sure I got on the boat, and I wasn't even guaranteed that I could get on the boat. So, you know, they do fill up. So make sure you're making your reservations early, and shouldn't have a problem. It's $65 to cross. And it's maybe an hour, you know. So we'll hit Victoria, have a nice dinner, and then we'll be on our way. So we've made it almost to the north end of the island here, come from Victoria all the way up the west side of the east side of the island. And we're heading to the west side of the island. So where we're at is, well, I'm not exactly sure where we're at, but it's more around Fort McNeil here, and we're heading up to Port Hardy, which is basically the end of the road, literally the end of the highway. And there are some dirt roads, and what we're gonna take Port Hardy is this one, past these two lakes here, which I understand have really good trout in them. And all the years I've been coming up here, I drive by them, I think, oh, these years I'm gonna bring a kayak and fish them. But one of these times I'll do that. But I guess there's really good fish in those lakes and nobody ever fishes them. But we'll come through here to Holberg and then wind around down to Winter Harbor. Now on that dirt road from Port Hardy around to Holberg and Winter Harbor, it's basically a dirt logging road. So that's one you gotta be careful on, have good tires. But it shouldn't be bad. It's been a lot better in recent years. So, and then where we're fishing is, you know, Quatsino Sound, and outside of Quatsino Sound all the way up to Cape Scott, and then down, well, it'll be down a little farther down here. So all this water here, it's like, you know, very remote, very good fishing. So that's why we put all this effort to get up here, and it's a great drive. We've got a beautiful day today, and the road's a good road coming to the south end of the island. It's a 4-lane highway. Then you get past Campbell River, turns into a 2-lane road, but it's all good road the whole way, and it's definitely worth doing the trip. So we'll get on up to Port Hardy, hang a left, and we should be there in no time, making time for dinner. And that's a good thing. Got good food at Ollie's. That's where we're going in Winter Harbor. So this is the dirt road, and this year it's in really good shape. There's a good sign for it now out on the highway, just a regular sign for Winter Harbor. So it's just about a mile before you get into the actual town of Port Hardy. There's a big sign that says Winter Harbor. Just take that and you're on your way. So one thing, you know, even though the road's really good shape, you gotta watch out for other cars, but also the big logging trucks. These big Canadian logging trucks, you know, they're bigger than ours, and they don't slow down for nothing. So yeah, just pay attention, and then see the power lines. You know, sometimes like out here in the middle of nowhere, and you think, oh, well, maybe I'm lost. Well, no, just the power lines. They go to Winter Harbor. So follow the power lines, you'll be fine. And there's signs. It really is no problem. Just take it easy, and you'll be catching fish in no time. Pulling a trailer, you know, if you want to bring your own boat up here, and all these got cabins where you know, like floating cabins that you can rent and just have a place to dock your boat, and it's a really cool operation. But there's I wouldn't drive your boat on this road. There's you can launch it, I think it's Cole Harbor, and then just run down Quatsino Sound all the way, you know. So basically you're just driving your boat this 40 kilometers instead of pulling the trailer over this rough road, because it is pretty rough. There's some spots where it's, you know, the good old Winter Harbor Road, but there's some potholes. But, you know, really beat up your boat trailer. But, you know, if you're interested in bringing your boat up here, you can do that. Okay, here's a place where, you know, you want to make sure you're paying attention to the sign and make sure you're going the right way. And they didn't used to have signs. Now I get signs, it's nice. But anyway, you just, we're, you know, explain to Ollie about what you want to do, and they can help you make sure you're getting, you know, your boat in the right place, and how to get there without having to pull your trailer down this road. Okay. Here we go. Oh man, look at these fancy signs they got now. We're going this way. Winter Harbor. 21 kilometers. Oh, heck yeah. We're gonna make it just fine for dinner. Yeah, one thing you might see around here are bears. Lots of bears. Not unusual to see some on the way. And then when you're out on the boat too, you can, a lot of times see bears that come down and feed along the shore. Okay, we made it to Winter Harbor. So Ollie's is, it's just up here on the left. There's hardly anybody lives here. In the wintertime, there's maybe two or three people that stay here all winter. And of course, there's
fishing industries. Quite a few people in the summer. But, so Ollie's is right here. So I'm on my way home after another successful trip to Winter Harbour. We got our fish. The weather was not the best I've ever seen here, you know, but it's just the way it is. They've had perfect weather all summer. And then we caught some wind, a little bit of rain, not too much rain at all, but we had a couple days where it was a little windier than you like. But we got out today and got our lingcod that we wanted and was able to do it fast. So we needed to because it was a little bumpy out there. But we got our fish, no problem, and I'm on the road. So the deal is you gotta work the ferries. Like I was planning on going home tomorrow, but we got in so early, decided, okay, well, I'm gonna give myself an extra day this week. So I am heading home, and what the trick with the ferries is they take 40%, I believe it is, or 30% of reservations. So I have a reservation for tomorrow night, but not for today. So I'm gonna shoot down to Nanaimo and see if I get the Tawasin ferry across, which I think leaves at 10:45. And I might make it in time and I might not. I could get there and there's no room on the boat, or I could just not get there in time. We'll see how it goes here. And if that's the case, I'll just spend the night in Nanaimo or go on down to Victoria and catch the early boat, hopefully, out of Victoria. So, you know, it's just the way it is with ferries. It's, you gotta be there. So, it was a good trip. Ollie's is a great place. You know, it's a great place for, you know, groups of people, families, you know, because he's got at least three big cabins, or really their houses, and then some, two or three smaller cabins and some other rooms. You know, you can handle quite a few people. And he's got nice big boats that make rough days on the water for weather a lot easier to deal with. So I've got my Yetis full of fish. I'm heading home and looking forward to another trip next year.